So when you call, you must answer. Research on your hands up. Let me tell my friend.
I don't jump like I never jump. Wave like I never wave. Wave like I never went before.
To show you I'm
sorry.
A new traveling buddy, it's my mom. Say hi to the folks. Yeah, so we are walking to our gate. I'm excited to start the vacation. So this is my mom's first time traveling out of the country, going back home since the pandemic started. So I'm really excited to start this trip with her and have her as my travel buddy. So we made it on the plane. Now we're on the plane. Now I'm in a middle seat. I usually like to have the window seat, and I do have the window seat with these tickets, but you know, I'm such a nice daughter.
Yeah, right.
What do you mean, yeah, right? So I let my mom have the window seat. This is her first time traveling out the country since the pandemic. How's it feel?
Good.
We can finally make it. Look at your faces of it.
It feels great. I love it. It feels great. Can't wait to get there.
Oh, it's annoying every time.
Well,
every
time counts, I can have some rum and coke.
Every time counts.
What else?
Nothing. See y'all later. And after an almost 5-hour plane ride, we finally made it to Trinidad, and the plane didn't even touch down good yet before everybody on the plane just couldn't wait to show their excitement. Someone took out their phone, Soka started playing, and it was just up from there. So if you can't tell, I absolutely love my people, and I am here for all the antics. Hello, 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 hello. Tell them we reach. We reach. She's not too happy with my camera usage. But she's gonna have to get used to it. It's been quite. This is still more lively than how it was when I came back in May. We finally made it outside now. Mommy, how's it feel to be back home?
Good.
Good.
Good. Very good.
She camera shy. Don't worry. We gonna get her out of that soon.
So if y'all don't know, I can be.
So when you call, you must answer.
My mom.
She will not be with my answer. Put your hands up.
There's no music.
But that didn't stop me. I had to give my aunt a little piece, you know. As soon as she came out the car to get us. So we finally made it to my family's house. This is my little baby cousin CJ. And then it was time for some food. I love my aunt so much. Every time I come, she always makes sure the first thing I have is a plate that's ready for me. So yeah, so arrival day was pretty much just a chill day. We stayed inside. It was really just about hanging around family. At one point, my aunt had this big bag of pigeon peas to shell. So my mom started shelling some, and that was pretty cool because she said it reminded her of her childhood, and that was so cool to see. Then I joined her for a little bit and shelled some peas, and then eventually I left her and my aunt to do it, and they had a great bonding moment over that. Then my brother and my niece got there. My niece didn't know I was coming, so she was like super excited to see me and nearly threw me down on the ground. But yeah, Sunday was just a cool vibe.
Oh God, now we're falling all over the place. Hi, Isabella.
Hi, hi.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is Monday morning, and gonna go do some beaching today before it gets crazy. Yes, I'm here trying to make my vlog, you know, and all the interrupting my vlog. as I was saying, I'm going to the beach before it gets crazy, because a lot of people are coming in to visit and a lot more people will come through. But yeah, so it's Monday, shouldn't be too bad, but it should be nice. I told her she could at least put her feet in the water, at least, but she said no. That's why I was asking for the beach chairs and stuff, so she could sit down. The granny passes away. We're on the way to the beach.
On to the beach.
So we are on our way to Maracas Beach, but before we actually get down there, the first thing I always like to do is stop at this lookout. Now the lookout, it's a place where there's a lot of local vendors selling all kinds of Trinity snacks and local eats. A lot of them are my faves. And see, this is why it's called the lookout, because you can see all the way down there, the views, the views. It was a little cloudy this day, so this really doesn't do it too much justice, but it's a must every time I go to Maracas. The weather this day was really playing games with us. The sun was out here, but later on the rain comes and it just kept going back and forth, but those people still had a great time. It's my brother. Say hi. You don't like to smile. You already met Mom Dukes at the beach. She don't go in the water, so she's just gonna be here chilling. And this is my niece Isabella. Well, you're already seeing her, but Isabella can't wait to be on the beach. What you making, girl? A sandcastle. Oh. Isabella, are you excited to be at the beach? And the first order of business after finding a spot on the beach, big and shark. All right, big and shark. I couldn't actually get me putting on the condiments because it was this whole situation going on, but in here I have pineapple, lettuce, cucumber, some type of thing that I don't remember what it's called, but it tasted good. Garlic sauce, tamarind sauce. Oh gosh, I think I forgot to put the pepper sauce. You got the pepper sauce. Yes. So it have no pepper sauce, but a lot of these things have pepper in it too, so. Right. So there's a whole situation going on here, but all worth it. Has been off and on and it's feeling cold, but this girl, look at this girl, ain't have a care in the world, not one. Come on, Isabella. Hey, Isabella. Hey. The same time, so I took my niece and we went over and hung out with them for a bit.
Let me tell my friend, it was a misunderstanding. Woo! I took it for granted. Touch you down, my friend.
I don't know where she got it from. And my niece proceeded to have a time in the water despite the rain. Are you wetting me, girl? What?
Get my cat stand on it.
Oh, so you're washing me off? You can wash me off. Wash me.
washing me off. Thank you.
Eventually, that rain was just coming down, so we finally wrapped it up. But we had such a good time.
All right, so this is what I got from when I went to the stopover at Maracas, what I showed you earlier, but I didn't get a chance to actually show you what was coming out of the bag. But here are some of my favorites, so I'm going to share it real quick. This is kumar. So it's basically like, I don't know, fried dough, I would say, kind of, with sugar. It's hard. Favorite candy of mine. Love it. This is sugar cake. And it is coconut, sugar, some other stuff, but it's another snack that I like to eat. This is tulum. It's something that I would say that's a little bit something that you have to have an acquired taste for. Well, not necessarily. I wouldn't say have to, but a lot of people would because it's kind of bitter. But this is with sugar, coconut, molasses. It's molasses based, but I love it. This is called pomsite. It's actually chow, but it's pomsite. So this is the fruit. The fruit is pomsite. And this is a style of how you preserve the fruit, which you refer to as chow, which is basically like some salt, lime, and some other little things to give it a pizzazz, but you know, we like to eat it that way. I have a next chow. These are cherries. So this is cherry chow. Can't wait to gobble this up. Sometimes you put a little pepper in it too. Trini's like pepper, but I don't have pepper in mine. It's a fly that keeps getting in my video. And this, dasheen chips. So it's dasheen, made chips out of it in the snack. And I'm going to take my time and eat these. So the noise in the background is actually my family speaking and talking in the back, but still gonna show you. All right. So this is the pomsite chow. So it's a little tangy, a little sweet, a little spicy, all the things I like. And if it's one thing about me, I'ma dance, and my family, they gonna dance too. So pretty much this end of the day, just chilling out with family and appreciating this lovely time. Good morning. So it's about 4:30 a.m. and I am officially heading to my first fete, which is a boat ride called Pree. Just here in the parking lot. It was actually supposed to start at 4, but you know, things always kind of start late. So I'm just here in the parking lot waiting for my friend who slept somewhere else because he was too tired for my next fete. Because, you know, fed after fed after fed. So he's getting dressed. But, yeah, once he finished up himself, we will get ready to get on the boat. So you see, he's finally ready.
Who?
Him. I already told him that you were getting ready, so. He's walking with the cooler and the ice.
I am ready. Finally, I'm ready.
And we bounce up Tony on the way. So we made it on the boat now. First thing you gotta do is set up your little area with your little cooler, and the boat is packed. And I don't really like people on top of me too much. I like to have space to free up. So eventually I opted to go upstairs where there was nobody because the music was actually pumping downstairs, but I just felt better going upstairs for the moment so I could breeze out. And it was actually really great because, you know, like I had all the space. I got to see when we took off. I got to see the sunrise, and slowly but surely my other friends started to follow suit, and then the music was pumping upstairs too as well, so it was all good.
Oh, right away!
Ride is hosted by Bungie Garland and his wife Anne. We headed back downstairs so we could check them out to a little performance before we got back to the park. Not too long after that, they served breakfast. It started to rain.
The rain won't let me live. But it better not rain like this, kind of Monday and Tuesday. That's all I have to say. Kind of Monday and Tuesday. Please. Glory.
And by that time, the girl just wanted to go home. So my friends and I, we went home to our respective places. But me? This was the end of my day. 10 o'clock. That was the end of my day, but I had so much fun and it was a great time. Good morning. So we've made our way down to Port of Spain. Gonna do a little, to be honest, I don't know what we're doing. We're just walking around and we go figure it out. And the first stop of us figuring it out was Lotus Trading. Now this store is really cool. It sells all kinds of like Trini eats and snacks, like preserved fruits and things, a lot of stuff that happen to be my faves. And you can also get things in wholesale sizes for good prices. The next stop was another one of my faves, Linda's Bakery. All right, so we're about to look at some of the treats we got. This is the fruit slice cake. Are you gonna taste it and do the honors of tasting it? Oh, it tastes it.
It's nice and moist.
Alright, next up, the beef pie. That was quick. How was it?
Good. All right.
So now we reach El Peco's. Gonna get something to eat because we is hungry. And I hear the food is good. So this is the plate I got. A little stew lamb, stew pork, bhaji rice, which is like a spinach, oil down, potato salad, and in here is actually a beef pastel, so I will show you that a little bit later.
I enjoy that.
You said you love it. How come you're eating it?
I want to save it for lunch.
Sure, I know that trick. All too well. Your mother does that too.
Do you like your food, Isabella?
Yes.
Can I see you eating your food?
You said you love it.
How's it taste?
Good.
What do you like the best? The chicken? Mm-hmm. I see your chicken. And this is me unwrapping the beef pastel that I mentioned earlier. I didn't feel myself eating it, but it was very moist inside and I enjoyed it. Hello. So good night. So it is now Tuesday night. No, it's Wednesday night. Look, I'm already getting my days mixed up. So anyway, you hear the speakers in the background. That's actually a DJ that's testing the speakers because they'll be playing on the road come this weekend. So, you know, lively right now. But any event, I am getting ready to go and pay a visit to my cousin who plays pan. So we're going to have a little chat about pan and I'm going to show you all their preparations as they're getting ready for the panorama finals that's coming up on Saturday. So excited. And this is my cousin Brandon. He's the captain of Skiffle Bunch Steel Orchestra. And we had a great conversation about the importance of pan, how he got involved, and what it just means to be able to do something and take part in something that's so important to the Trinidadian culture. I will get more into detail in that in another video that I have coming up that's specifically about the steel band, but for now, here's a glimpse of what I and the rest of my family got a chance to see this night when they were practicing for the upcoming Panorama Finals. It was just so amazing, and I'm so appreciative to my cousin for allowing me to come and talk about all these things, and it was a perfect way to end the day.